Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the fourth and final part of my TNA documentary series. This took a little longer to come out because I wanted to focus on some other content, but we are back. So, in the last part, we looked at the GFW situation, as well as Billy Corgan coming in and leaving, the departures of Dixie Carter and the TNA name, the arrival of Anthem and Impact Wrestling, and the last three parts, we looked at why TNA ultimately lost its popularity, and looked at some of its worst moments, both on screen and off screen. So today, we're going to be looking at why Impact Wrestling today is actually really, really good, and why I recommend watching, and how it differs from the actual TNA product. And we also talk about the somewhat recent announcement that TNA is being revived. We'll get onto that though. Before we do get into the video, be sure to subscribe with notifications on. The majority of you guys watching these videos aren't actually subscribed, according to my analytics. So go ahead, help me out, subscribe. It's free, with notifications on, so you never miss a video. And let's hit 420 likes, because that's a funny number. And let's get right into this video now. After Impact terminated their partnership with GFW, they looked to get back on track. They reverted back to their original titles and quite a fair few people were signed. The likes of Sami Callihan and OVE and Taya Valkyrie all signed for Impact either just after or just before the termination with GFW, and all these people are big stars with Impact today. In December of 2017, more changes would be made for Impact with the hirings of Don Callis and Scott D'Amore as EVPs to help with day-to-day operations. And then at the January 10th tapings, they reverted back to a traditional four-sided ring, and we saw the return of Austin Aries, as well as the debuts of Brian Cage, the Lucha Bros, Kiera Hogan, and Sue Young. Their first pay-per-view since these new changes was Redemption in April 2018. And it was a really good show. It saw Austin Aries defend his world title against Pentagon and Phoenix in a triple threat. Matt Sydal defended the X Division title against Petey Williams. And most importantly, we saw the debut of Tessa Blanchard, who is someone I'm going to be talking about a lot in this video. The rest of the year, Impact continued putting on good pay-per-views. Slammiversary saw Moose vs. Austin Aries for the world title, Pentagon vs. Sami Callihan, and Tessa Blanchard made her debut match in a pay-per-view that many people said was one of the best of the year. The final pay-per-view of 2018 for Impact was Bound for Glory, and yet again, another good pay-per-view, though it did have its share of controversy with the whole Austin Aries versus Johnny Impact match, but I made a whole other video on that, which you can watch, link in the description, after you're done with this video, watch that to kind of catch up on that situation, because it's a bit long. So that was just a really quick summary of Impact's year in 2018, and overall a really good year for them. The company took an entirely new presentation and overall presented a product that was different from anything else, and that's thanks in part to the new management as well as their new signings. However, there was one more thing to take place for Impact. On December 21st, 2018, it was announced that Impact's weekly show would be moving from Pop TV to the Pursuit channel. Pursuit is not a popular channel. In fact, it's a hunting channel, and there is nothing on there remotely similar to wrestling whatsoever. So why Impact went on there is kind of beyond me. But with this setback of switching to a less popular TV channel, Impact took initiative and announced that after this, Impact would be airing for free live on Twitch every week. So yes, you can still watch it on Twitch every week, and I'd say do it, okay? Follow them, twitch.tv/impactwrestling. I'm not being paid to say that. And 2019 has been a very good year for Impact despite the setback of being on Pursuit, and they have solidified themselves as a company that a lot of people watch weekly, including myself. What I'm going to do now is I'm going to go over some standout wrestlers and storylines that have really shown in Impact this year, starting off with Taya Valkyrie. So Taya Valkyrie defeated Tessa Blanchard to win the TNA Knockouts title at Homecoming on January 5th, and since then has remained champion and gone on to become the longest reigning Knockouts champion in history. Since then, she has defended the title successfully against Jordan Grace, she defeated Havoc, Rosemary, and Sue Young in a Monsters Ball match, and very recently she defeated Tennille Dashwood at Bound for Glory. She currently finds herself in an alliance with Johnny Bravo and is going to be defending the title against Jordan Grace and ODB at Hard to Kill in January. She was also aligned with her real-life husband, Johnny Impact, before he left. Speaking of whom, let's talk about Johnny Impact because he also had a very good year with Impact this year. He came into the year as the Impact World Champion, and before even going into 2019, he was having feuds with the likes of Matt Sydal, Killer Cross, and of course, the controversial feud with Austin Aries. His great matches and storylines combined with his name power helped to get more eyes on Impact. In fact, it was me seeing he was the world champion that got my attention back to Impact again. Johnny would get into a feud with Brian Cage, which saw him turning heel and aligning with Taya Valkyrie, obviously his real life wife, with their marriage being acknowledged on screen, and they were such a brilliant duo. He would lose the title to Brian Cage at Rebellion, ending his reign at 196 days and making it the third longest world title reign in TNA / Impact history. Impact has now departed from the company and is going to be making his in-ring return to WWE very soon, but it's no doubt that during his time in the company, Johnny made an impact. And I promise you, no pun was intended there, okay? Please don't hurt me. Next up, let's talk about Brian Cage, the man who beat Johnny Impact for the world title. And let me just tell you right now, Brian Cage is a machine. I was first introduced to him at the Over the Budget Battle Royale at All In, and he is just so damn good. After Brian Cage defeated Johnny Impact to win the world title at Rebellion, he was attacked by the debuting Michael Elgin. The two fought at Slammiversary for the world title with Brian Cage defeating him in a very hard-hitting match, and he would then begin feuding with Sami Callihan. He retained over Callihan at Bound for Glory, but would lose the title to him on an episode of Impact. Before we get on to the final two people who you all probably can guess who it's going to be, let's talk about some of the shining lights in the different divisions of Impact, starting off with the tag division and LAX. LAX, who are now known as Proud and Powerful in AEW, came into the year as Impact Tag Champions. They had an absolutely fantastic feud with the Lucha Brothers, having some of the best matches of the year with them. They would lose the titles to Lucha Bros during the Impact Mexico tapings, but would reclaim the titles at Rebellion on April 28th. Eventually, LAX would lose the titles to the North in July, and would leave TNA in August to join AEW, where they're doing pretty well for themselves. I also noticed I said TNA, but I'm just gonna leave that in, why not? And then let's talk about the Knockouts division, because the Knockouts division in Impact is really good, and some people say it's the best women's division in wrestling today. I already mentioned Taya Valkyrie, but the likes of Rosemary, Kiera Hogan, Sue Young, Jessica Havoc, Tennille Dashwood, Katie Forbes, and Madison Rain, just to name a few, are some of the other amazing names in this division. You might have noticed that I didn't mention Jordynne Grace in this list, and that's because I think she has shown through this year in particular herself, and I want to talk a bit about her. While she didn't win the title this year, she did feud with Taya Valkyrie for the title in a really good feud, and she's a very big draw for Impact in terms of YouTube views. Like, I'm not even lying. She has one of the most viewed videos of TNA / Impact on YouTube. She can kill it in any division that she's in, whether it's Knockouts division or against the men. You saw the Call Your Shot Battle Royal at Bound for Glory. She was going toe-to-toe with Madman Fulton and making it look easy. And she will be competing against Taya Valkyrie and ODB in a triple threat match for the Knockouts title. And I personally think she's most likely going to win. And I hope she does. Also, another Knockout that really stood out this year was Scarlett Bordeaux. She has since moved on from Impact and is now in NXT, but she, like Jordynne, was a very big draw for YouTube views. And she spent most of her time in Impact this year not even wrestling the other Knockouts, but rather wrestling the men, facing the likes of Glenn Gilberti, the Desi Hit Squad, and teaming with Fala Bar and having a mini feud with OVE. She helps to normalize intergender wrestling in Impact, and that's important, especially considering the final two people we're going to be talking about, who you can probably guess. I'm going to talk about Tessa Blanchard and Sami Callihan all in one, because in my opinion, at least, they have had the best feud of the entire year in all of wrestling. The two of them have had a heated rivalry that isn't even over yet. They first faced off at Slammiversary in a match that was made the main event due to all the buzz surrounding it. Sami Callihan would win that match and would then go on to beat her again at Unbreakable in a world title number one contendership match. Sami Callihan went on to beat Brian Cage for the world title, and shortly after, Tessa Blanchard won a number one contenders match against Daga, Rich Swann, Brian Cage, and Michael Elgin, and will face Sami Callihan at Hard to Kill in January for the world title. Tessa Blanchard could make history, and I pray that she does, because she has by far been the best female wrestler of the year in every company. I think Becky Lynch has been great. I think Rhea Ripley's been great. But for me, Tessa Blanchard is the number one on that list. Fact is, she's the boss of the men's division in Impact and easily their best wrestler there and their biggest star. And Sami Callihan, as good as he is, and as in fact amazing as he is brilliant too. I think this is Tessa's time. And if she doesn't win the title, kind of makes you wonder what they did this all for. But I hope she does. So let's talk about why this video is titled The Revival of TNA Wrestling. And that's mainly because of the fact that they have revived themselves and the fact they're putting on really good shows, but also because in November, Ethan Page, who is a current tag champion in Impact, tweeted out saying, "I remember getting talked to for tweeting about TNA. Mania weekend, Impact Wrestling is bringing TNA back for one night. Yes, indeed." I hope this is actually happening. I think it should be if a wrestler is tweeting it out and the tweet hasn't been deleted to this day. But Impact could potentially be doing a one night only TNA rebrand, bringing back the TNA name and having a show on WrestleMania weekend, which I think is such a great idea, and I'll definitely be watching it if it does happen. But yeah guys, that's going to do it for this video. If you did enjoy, smack the like button. Before I do outro, I would like to just say a huge thank you for the support on this series. This series kind of, in a way, I guess, changed my life. Obviously, you might be wondering, how has it changed your life? Because, you know, my channel was very much dead in the water before I started this series. I had 170,000 subscribers getting 1,000 views a video or less. And then I did that the day TNA Wrestling died and got 300,000 views. And since then, all my videos do really well, and it seems that you guys really enjoy the TNA stuff, and I'm making this content that I'm really passionate about now, and way better than anything I've made in the past, and you guys are enjoying it, and I'm really glad, and I'm really thankful that you guys enjoy the content, and thank you for sticking around, thank you for watching the series, and thank you for helping bring my passion back for this channel, because let me tell you, I came very close to quitting multiple times, in fact many times over the last couple years. And right now, no chance I want to quit anytime soon. So yeah, that was just a quick thank you. Me getting all cringy and sappy. Oh, sorry. But yeah, smash the like button. Let's hit 420 likes, like I said before. Subscribe, notifications on. My Twitter is at Topton Wrestling, and my Instagram is at I'm Tom Bell. Thank you for all the support on this four-part series. It's been amazing. See you all soon. Goodbye, and keep on rolling.